In the last video of the series about Docker, we have seen how to use already existing Docker images that someone else has created. But in this video, we'll create our own Docker image that will run a simple Python web service like the one you would use to deploy your machine learning models. Hi, for those of you who don't know me, I'm Johannes Frey, but you can simply call me Joe, and I've been working as a software engineer for more than 10 years. I'm based in Stuttgart, Germany, and I'm self-employed and run a company that does programming, data science, and DevOps. Since at some point you also want to deploy your awesome machine learning models into production. The real beauty with Docker is that you can easily create your own Docker images. To create your own Docker image, you need to create a Docker file, which is basically just a text file with the name Dockerfile and specific commands written into it. This file specifies what software and files should be included in your Docker file. Docker offers you several commands that can be used in your Docker file. And you will see some of them in the example that we will create now. To demonstrate how to create a Docker image, we'll be using a small Python web service, similar to one you would use to deploy a machine learning model to be consumed by someone. All right, so this is the Docker file we will be using for this tutorial. First, let's have a quick look at a web service. Actually, there are two web services in this directory, AppPy and App2Py. We will start with AppPy. AppPy offers two endpoints, one that prints a message as well as the content of the environment variable named content, which is that one, and the other lists all the files in the directory hoch yopsel mopsel, and this is this one. App2Py, on the other hand, offers just one endpoint with a different message, this one. In the real world, such an endpoint would, for example, call your machine learning model and output a prediction. But let's keep things simple for this tutorial, since this is focused on Docker and not on machine learning. Now that we have seen the web services, let's have a quick look at the Docker file required to run them, and we will do this line by line. There is the rule that a Docker file needs to start with a from command to tell Docker the base image. In this case, we use Ubuntu in the version 18.04 as our base image, which means that we have access to everything that is installed in that base image and we can add additional stuff to it, which we will do in just a minute. The next command in this Docker file is env, which introduces an environment variable named content and sets the string blub as its default value. Next comes the expose command. This command serves two purposes. First, it tells the user of this Docker file that he needs to provide a port mapping for this port, so it serves as documentation. But one could also use the minus capital P parameter with docker run to have all ports exposed with the expose command mapped to random ports on the host, so that you don't need to provide explicit port mapping. Now is the time where we install the software required for our web service. Since it is a Python web service, it would be a good idea to ensure that we have Python installed as well as pip. With the run command, we are able to execute arbitrary commands, and in this case, we use apt, Ubuntu's package manager, to install Python and pip. Using the copy command, we copy the requirements.txt from the Docker build context in a specific path inside the Docker image. We will talk about the Docker build context in a minute when we will be talking about actually building the Docker image. By doing that, we can ensure that every time we run this image, the same libraries will be used. With the command workdir, we can set a specific working directory, which means that every command that we will execute afterwards will be executed inside this directory. So next, we use the run command again to use pip to install the Python dependencies listed in the requirements.txt file. Since we switched the workdir, we are installing the dependencies from the file app-requirements.txt, since we switched to workdir app, so app is prepended to the requirements.txt, so that means we are installing this one. Now we use the copy command again and copy everything from the Docker build context, which in this case is the current directory, in the slash app directory inside the Docker image. Now comes an essential part for running the image. The entry point command specifies what exactly inside this Docker image gets executed when we run it. So in this case, we will execute Python. And the cmd command goes hand in hand with the entry point command, specifying what to pass to the entry point. So in this case, the name of the Python script to be executed. An important thing to mention is that the cmd command can be overridden by the docker run cli command, and I will show you an example soon. So with that explained, let's actually build the Docker image and play with it for a bit. To build that image, you need to use the Docker CLI command docker build, and every time you change something inside the Docker file, you need to rerun the docker build command. The -t parameter specifies a tag, which is a name for our Docker image. And the dot specifies the Docker build context. The Docker build context is where Docker looks for a Docker file and specifies what files are available for referencing in the Docker file while building the image. Like, for example, what files from the local machine can be copied into the Docker image. We will go into more detail about this and other commands and parameters that the Docker CLI offers in the next video. So please make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified as soon as the new video drops. So now we execute the build command. After the build command is done, we have our first Docker image and we are finally able to run it. So well done, and give yourself a round of applause and pat you on the back. So let's run it. We provide a port mapping as well as the name of the Docker image that we've built. With this, we are able to call the web service and its endpoints using the mapped port. As you see, this is the root endpoint of our Python web service, and it prints the message and the environment variable with the default value of blob. We can now also set the environment variable with the docker run command. And when we reload the page now, we see that the environment variable changed. Now let's have a look at the list endpoint. Whoops, the list endpoint fails, and it fails because the directory /hu/yopselmopsel does not exist inside our Docker image or inside our Docker container yet. So for this to work, we need to use a bind mount and mount this directory inside our Docker container. So let's do it. So with the -v parameter, we can bind mount a local directory to a directory inside our Docker container. So here we mount our current directory from our local machine to the directory /hu/yopselmopsel inside our Docker container. And if you run it now and refresh the page, now we actually see the contents of our current directory. Also remember when we talked about the cmd command going hand in hand with the entry point command, and that is possible to override it. So let's do it now. So if we add the parameter after the name of the Docker image, this parameter is used as the cmd command. So in this case, we add the app2py script, and when we run it now, go to our root command, to our root path, then we see this is a different app now. Now you have seen how easy it is to create your own Docker image, and the best part? Now you could upload it to Docker Hub and share it with a coworker, the community, or anybody. And they will get a runnable application without the need of installing any of the dependencies on their local machines. You could even grab the Docker image and deploy it to some cloud provider like AWS or Google Cloud and make it available on the internet. I hope you enjoyed this video and have learned something. If so, it would be great if you would consider subscribing to my channel and going crazy on this like button, bell icons, and all the buttons and icons you can find. So, see you in the next video.